Okay, so we're recording. good morning, everyone. Thank you so much for showing up here this morning. I hope everybody's having a spectacular day. George, thank you for leading such an amazing team. I am super grateful that on this morning I get to share my partner in funding and the man that I know for the last 25 years. He's one of the leading commercial brokers and also bankers in the area. And so when you guys requested yesterday, who do we have that does commercial funding? Right at the top of my head, the only person in my mind always is Chaz Kauffman. So Chaz, welcome to Lifestyle's morning call. And thank you for taking the time to connect with all of us today and give us some insights and be able to answer some questions of our team here. So Chaz, please introduce yourself to the team. Thank you.
Great. Thanks for having me. Can you guys hear me okay?
Yes.
Okay, great. So yes, Fran and I have a longstanding relationship, goes back probably 25 years now. I appreciate the confidence, Fran. Just tell you real quick kind of who we are, what we do. We're a commercial mortgage banking firm, a little boutique firm out of Red Bank, New Jersey. Company's been around since 1986. We do all things commercial. So permanent financing on apartments, retail, office, industrial. We do construction financing on all the same product types, hotels. I know some of you sit in the office in Rahway, New Jersey. We finance the construction for the Mint. That's one of our projects that we funded. So we did the construction and permanent financing for the first building, the construction for the second building. We're actually looking at doing permanent financing on that building now. We do stuff all over. Our main business is kind of East Coast, but we've done deals in Arizona, California. Typically we're $1.5 million kind of north. Largest deal we've done so far is $245 million. Love to say we do those all day long. We don't. They're nice when they come through, but you know, most of our business is in that $2 to $50 million is where we do most of our business. Again, we've got relationships with about 75 different lending institutions. So typically we can find, a home for specific permanent financing, construction financing, need for a client. Just recently closed a couple of deals down in Florida, a couple of deals in Sarasota. Looking at more opportunities down there, obviously, because of that, the way the market is kind of exploding down in that Florida market. So again, been around, love to see if there's any way we could, increase our relationship with Fran and your group. Look forward to any questions you have and any opportunities. Love to discuss it with you guys and see how we could work together.
Hi, Lauren. Yes, we can drop his contact here. Chaz, if you can share the information for the company so like that we can get the team to, we can have the team connect. And Lauren, also feel free to connect through me. We work hand in hand. Actually, we have a handful of projects that we're working on together in Florida right now. He's always my go-to because of what he has been able to do. So I wanted to open this conversation, Chaz.
Let me start off with that. First off, Chaz, thank you.
I'm sorry, you're breaking up. Somebody was trying to say something.
That's George. He's trying to speak.
Ah, okay. Georgie, I know your internet is bad. I don't know if you want to type it. Chaz, he wants to know what kind of deals can you land on?
So real quick, lending, if someone's bought an acquisition, we can arrange, purchase money mortgage. Typically, depending on the product type, lenders are looking for anywhere between 25 and 30% down, but lending on office buildings, retail, apartments, office, I don't want to kid you right now, is probably one of the toughest products to do in the market. Obviously, as you can imagine, people are gone more to a remote work style. Lenders are very, very skeptical of what the office market looks like on an ongoing basis going forward. For the simple fact is, as leases roll, they anticipate people are going to either vacate that lease or they're going to renegotiate and take a much smaller lease. So office is a very difficult product right now. Obviously, the hot product is multifamily on the permanent side, as well as industrial. The industrial market for the last couple of years has been on fire. So those are the type, hotels, owner occupied is a little bit more difficult. We do have some lenders that will do that. So if it's a business that's operating, out of a real estate holding, we can do that. We have some SBA lenders that will, piggyback with us on that type of product. And SBA is completely different than your traditional bank lending. So that's typically 10% down. It has different bells and whistles that go along with it as far as structure. But the main business that we do is, with our banks, our life insurance companies, our debt funds, as well as our CMBS, but the CMBS market again has slowed down a little bit because of the nature of the product on selling those bonds in the secondary market. But we can lend on pretty much any product type, again, with the different relationships that we have with the different lenders.
Chaz, we have that question here about fitness facilities, and George was also asking on smallest multifamily that we can lend on, 5 units and above. Can you talk further on that, please?
Yeah. So, and again, so let's stay with the fitness facility. Again, that is depending on the sponsorship behind it. If it's someone that's kind of a national firm, obviously much easier. An LA Fitness or somebody along those lines, a lifestyle. Gym, those are the type of products that are a little bit easier to finance. If it's individual, structure on the gyms, it's a little bit more difficult. Obviously, we'd go towards more local and, with one of our institutions in that market. And I'm sorry, friend, the second question was multifamily.
Yeah, multifamily. So what's the smallest multifamily that we would look at?
Yeah, and again, typically we try to stay above that $1.5 million. Obviously, I know that in certain markets, an 8-family, 10-family is not going to hit that. But again, what I would suggest is if you have an opportunity, please share it with Fran and myself. The one thing that, we're very, one of our main points is making sure that we can tell you what we can do. More importantly, we can tell you what we can't do. And if it's something we can't do, we'll give you suggestions on, maybe reach out to this person. It might just be easier. It's just one of those things where it may not be beneficial for us to work on it, but we'll try to guide you any way we can and try to get the deal done for you. But, we've got lending programs with different Fannie Freddie products that are in the small loan program. Typically, they want to start around $750,000 and above. And they go from $750,000 to about $7.5 million. And it's a streamlined process. But then we also have a lot of other banks and small life insurance companies that would look at those products as well. And they'll do deals, on the commercial, the term is usually 5, 7, or 10. You can get a 10-year term with 2 5-year rate resets. The amortization on multifamily industrial will be 30. Where office retail, typically is 25. We've got the ability to kind of structure around all those different types of terms and amortizations. The one thing, depending on the size of the deal, as far as multifamily industrial, we can do those typically non-recourse, which means that the lender doesn't sign personally, it's for the asset only. But again, every deal in commercial, I don't want to kid you, is unique and specific to itself. What we'll do is we'll try to get back to you if you can get us a quick, hey, we've got a client either buying something or refinancing a product. Here's the kind of the parameters, where does this fit? What kind of structure, what kind of terms, rates, and we'll try to facilitate that and get that back to you, because we know timing is critical, especially in this market as it's getting, you know, more difficult to get financing in place.
Chaz, thank you for actually stating that, because in the Florida market, what I'm also seeing is a lot of development sites that the team working probably with about 10 to 12 team members right now that have shared some commercial sites, and you know, their caps and the way that they're reviewing it has some different parameters. So based on what you're seeing right now in the market, can you give a little bit of your thoughts as to on these development sites, since we have, I know, a consensus right now in the our funding industry, where some banks are pulling away from doing commercial, that's not true, construction loans, and a lot of them are just looking at the reset loans, right? I mean, we're working with banks that are only doing reset loans right now. So can you talk a little bit further around that, just to be able to help our teams that are working in that space? Thank you.
No problem. So yeah, it's very important. You know, if we were having this conversation 6 months ago, it's completely different than it is today in the world. Construction financing, again, we do quite a bit of construction financing. It's what I kind of focus on. I enjoy it. It is extremely, extremely difficult right now. The banks are kind of pulling back. Obviously, construction is the financing is typically based on prime rate. So I'm sure if you guys are following it, you know, a little over a year ago, prime was 3.5. Now prime is 8.25. So construction is always a floating rate deal. So their interest rate, when if it was prime plus one, you know, when it was 3.5, was a 4.5 rate. If they're prime plus one, they're now paying 9.25 on that same construction loan. Huge difference in the cash flow needs for the builder developer kind of going forward. There are, I would say, out of the probably 30 banks that are kind of our go-to on the construction financing, I'm going to say 25 of them are out of the market completely right now and sitting on the sidelines. They're seeing how the existing portfolio of construction loans are going to pan out. Obviously, because same with prime rate, the interest rates, you know, have risen. So a deal that, you know, 6 months ago, you know, the permanent loan rate would have been kind of in the fives is now kind of, you know, in the sixes. And that 1% difference on the cash flow, which is what most, if not all, you know, commercial real estate is really based on, is, you know, that cash flow ability to pay back your financing. That extra point makes a big difference in the available cash flow to pay that debt service. So it's a tough time to get construction financing. We are still getting things done, but much, much more difficult. It's people need to have experience. More importantly, in the market today, people need to have a financial statement that shows true liquidity, that they can kind of either right-size the loan if needed or cover the cost overruns in construction. If someone's going into a project and it's their first deal in construction or they have limited experience, it's very, very difficult to get that done in today's world. You know, will that change? Yes, I'm sure it will. But right now and over the next, you know, in my opinion, 3 to 6 months, it's going to stay that way. I've got several lenders in the last, you know, 2 to 3 weeks have told me that they are out of the construction market for the next 12 months. They're not entertaining any new deals at all.
Thank you so much. Also, so the team might know, there are some transactions in which we are able to provide equity to be able to substantiate the shortfall on the debt. Can you speak about that a little bit? And guys, thank you for your time, and we'd love to get to your questions after that. Thank you.
Yeah, real quick, we do have a couple of groups that will do preferred equity or mezzanine financing on construction. It's difficult to get mezzanine financing because the lenders typically do not want any intervening liens on the property. So they look for it to be true equity or partnership equity. So we have different groups and or builder developers that will either come in on the preferred equity side or partner with somebody to get that construction, you know, project or funding. You know, put in place to get the development done. So obviously those are much, much more difficult to get done because you're talking about, in essence, partnering up with somebody, even though it's considered preferred equity, everything has to kind of be aligned so that the development and the repayment of that preferred equity kind of comes into play. Sometimes we have it, the ability where guys will come in, they'll stay into the deal and become a limited partner. Other times we've got groups that will come in, they will fund at the ownership level. So they'll come in at the operating agreement level and they fund. And then when the project is either sold, if it's condos or, you know, built to sell as a completed building, or if it's an apartment or, you know, retail building with a refinance that actually gives the sponsor the ability to then buy that person or that preferred equity group back out, and then they retain 100% of the building themselves going forward. Again, each deal is very unique and specific on that. A lot of different parameters come into play, but same thing, if something does come up, you know, love the opportunity for you to bounce that over to Fran and myself and see, you know, what it is. And again, we'll jump on a call and run through it and kind of, you know, discuss what opportunities we can present to you and your client for that.
And guys, we also have a fund that we work with, which is an aggressive fund. Obviously, those aggressive funds are going to cost more. But some people, depending on their structure, depending on their project, are very open to that. Chaz and I have done a handful of those. So, you know, please be able to ask. Let me see here, Gigi, you want to ask your question, sweetheart?
Yes. Hey, Chaz, thank you so much for doing this. I have a question. I'm working with a few residential investors. So some of them have duplexes, triplexes, and of course the max would be, you know, a 4-unit building. And mm-hmm. they do want to expand into those 6-8 unit options. They've never done commercial, to be quite frank. I haven't either. And so what would be some, like, I would like to brief them on what are the main differences between residential versus commercial financing? Just something that out of the bag that we need to be aware of. Is it experience? Is it more money down? Like, what are the big ticket differences there?
So the answer is yes. So it's a little bit of everything, right? So it's going to be experience. It's going to be more money down. It's going to be structure on the loan. So typically I would assume that these guys that are doing these, you know, 1-2 family, you know, the duplex units, they probably have gotten financing on traditional residential mortgages, which will give you a 30-year mortgage.
Correct.
Fixed. So again, on commercial, the way that commercial is typically done is everything is a balloon payment. In other words, shorter term, longer amortization. And the reason that is because on commercial, the beauty of commercial is that, you know, obviously you talk to your accountant, but to a certain extent, when you take debt on, it's debt, it's not income. So that's the beauty on the commercial side is, let's say they buy this building, let's just keep it simple, $1 million, they have to put 25% down. You know, after the 5-year term, they paid the loan down from $750,000 down to $700,000. It's now worth, let's call it, you know, $1.2 million. They can take 75% on a refinance back out. So we refinance them after that first term at $800,000. That $100,000 from the $700,000 to the $800,000, again, that's debt, that's not income. In essence, that's tax-free money. Obviously, there's issues when you get to a certain basis, things along those lines. But that's really the beauty of commercial real estate, is to be able to recapitalize, then take that extra $100,000, invest into your next project.
Okay.
The difference is really going to be, in my opinion, is the structure of the financing they're going to get. They're not going to get a 30-year mortgage that's fixed, where it's something they can put it to bed and leave it alone. It's constantly going to, you know, evolve. It'll be either a 5, 7, or 10-year term. The payments will be based on 25 or 30-year amortization. So the payments will be based on if it was a 25-year loan or 30-year loan, just that shorter term. And again, it's the, you know, if they're stepping from, let's say, if they've got a couple singles and duplexes and they're stepping into a, let's call it a 6 or an 8 family, a little bit easier. If they're trying to step into a 30 to 40 unit, a little bit more difficult. You know, they're going to want to know that they've got kind of that management expertise and can really, you know, manage that next level up, if you will. But listen, one of our very good clients, as a matter of fact, and again, you know, Gigi, I'm not sure where you sit, but the project that, again, we did in Rahway, we financed those guys. It was Rob and Jim Caulfield, and I don't know if any of you guys know that name, but they've been a client of ours for probably 25 years. Our first project with them was a four-family unit in Hoboken, New Jersey. They're now building several thousand units a year. So, listen, there's, you know, we've started with guys that, you know, have started at that lower level and, you know, have really kind of grown into that top tier developer. So, and again, if something comes up, Gigi, please reach out to myself, Fran. And if you need me to jump onto a call with you or your clients, you know, Fran and I will make ourselves available.
That's interesting that you say that, Chaz. So it's a 5-year and then a balloon payment. So all those multifamilies that were purchased in 2018 that now have a balloon payment coming up with the interest rate so high, that could be an opportunity for some multifamily to flood the market, right?
It's absolutely going to be there's, and again, so you're exactly right. So you have people that, you know, let's keep 2018, we're, you know, rolling now. They had rates that were in the, you know, in the mid threes. I mean, we did some deals that were, you know, 3.25, 3.10. They're rolling. So now that same deal is going to have a rate of, you know, at best right now, 5.5 to 6.25. You know, their interest rate carry on that mortgage has doubled. There's going to be people that will be able to, you know, either rewrite the, resize their loan. But there's going to, in my opinion, I think there's going to be a fair amount of people that are going to say, this doesn't cash flow at the levels I need, and I'm going to need to sell this. So I think you are going to see some opportunity, especially through 2024 in that exact thing, in exact market where people are going to look to resell their property because it's not going to make economic sense for them for what they bought it at and their original cash flows. So yes.
Perfect. Thank you.
Absolutely.
Chaz, can you, they're asking for, can you share your information on the, please there under the chat, if you could just share your website so that they can reach out.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much. Gigi, those are great questions and something Chaz and I are laughing about all the time right now. It's like, wow, this is going to be a very interesting market with a lot of interesting opportunities coming up because of where we are, right? And we're because of where it's going to be spinning out. So great questions. I want to be able to respect everybody's time. I know we usually do these calls for a half hour, and it's great to see you all here. Does anybody have any other questions that we can help at this point before we sign off? Okay, so the chat room is...
Yeah, give me 1 second. I'll throw my contact information. I'm going to just send my website. Yeah. If that's okay. You can click on that. I'll send my website and my email address. Please email me. I'll flip anything back to you. You guys can just reach out at any time to discuss anything.
We'll wait for you to do that. George, thank you for always bringing value to the team. And Chaz, thank you for taking up your time to come on board and be able to support. I'm very excited to be growing this commercial team. We have an amazing group of agents that are here doing what you do, which is really caring about bringing value to all their investors and buyers in both the residential and commercial space. So did you get that in there? Let's see.
I got mine. Give me one more second. I'd like my email as well as my website's there. Again, please feel free to shoot me an email. And I'll respond to you with my full contact information, but I sent the website as well. But when I respond to you, it's my footer has everything in there, my cell number as well. So feel free to reach out anytime. And I appreciate, George and yourself putting this together and giving me the opportunity to come in and talk. Love to expand our relationship and anything we can do to help you guys, love to discuss it. So please, at any time, feel free to reach out.
Thank you so much. Lauren, yes, we do have
thank you so much. Sorry I couldn't be involved too much because my internet was bad, but I appreciate you so much for taking the time.
No, thank you.
Lauren, sweetheart, I do have a commercial WhatsApp. We're separating it between Florida and New York, the New Jersey market, but I just started putting everybody together because we're right now working both markets with agents. So Gigi, I hope you got my invite as well. So Lauren, if you could just send me over your info to my phone number, and then I'll add you to our WhatsApp commercial.
Awesome. I just don't have your phone number. That's the only
thing. It's on my business card. I shared the business card on there. Did you receive that?
No, I don't see the business card.
That's right, honey. I'll put it again. Gigi, can you do me a favor, honey? Can you help me send that info to Lauren so that we can connect, please?
Absolutely.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Have a great day, bye-bye. Everyone.
Thank you.
Have a great day.
Thank you. Thank you for your time.
Fran, I didn't see his contact info.
I'll send it to you guys on the right now. Let me stop recording. Hold on a second.